If you're new to Stable Diffusion, this is the video for you. I wanted to create this video series for any new user to really just understand the jargon of Stable Diffusion and to make sense of everything that's out there, because it can be a very deep rabbit hole. By the end of the video series, you'll be able to take these concepts and apply them to any Stable Diffusion platform, whether locally or online. First off, what is Stable Diffusion? Think of it as this massive database that is probably terabytes worth, shrunk down to a 2 gigabyte file. And then it goes through a diffusion process that breaks down these images into noise. And when you enter a text prompt, it creates an image based on your text. We don't have to go deep into that whole process. I just want you to understand the basic concept of Stable Diffusion. One of the biggest reasons why there's a lot of hype around it is because it's open source, meaning anyone like you and I can download it, pop it in a certain program, which we'll talk about soon, and create our own images totally for free. Now that might be all fine and dandy, but how do you run Stable Diffusion? Well, there's three things you need. First of all, you need a computer that meets certain criteria. Secondly, you'll need a program to run it on your computer. And thirdly, you'll need a model that will basically create the images. Now, in terms of computer specs, Stable Diffusion can run on most computers. However, the biggest factor to consider is your graphics card, otherwise known as a GPU. On the GPU, there's something called VRAM, which is the graphics card's memory. This is what's needed to run Stable Diffusion quickly. Now, with that being said, some programs you can run it on as little as 2 or 3 gigabytes. But nowadays, the way things are moving, I would say 8 gigabytes is the minimum. Basically, the more VRAM you have, the better. Now, if we look at this graphics card we see here, you see it's got 8 gigabytes of VRAM. The other thing to consider is that most of the local platforms benefit from something called CUDA cores, which is on NVIDIA graphics cards. Unfortunately, that's just the way it is. Now, if you have an AMD card, you can likely still run Stable Diffusion, but using a Linux environment. And if you're a Mac user, most platforms will run on an M1 chip or an M2. Technically, you could run Stable Diffusion just on your CPU without the graphics card, but it's not the best way to go about it because it'll take several minutes to generate one image. Now, let's assume you have the required specs to run Stable Diffusion on your computer. The next thing you need is some sort of program or platform to run it. It could be pretty overwhelming to decide which program to use, so I'm going to give you a few suggestions. The first one I'd recommend is Easy Diffusion. It comes with an easy installer. You just download it, run it, and it'll install everything that you need. And the user interface is very user-friendly. And you're also able to install plugins to access other features of Stable Diffusion. The next group I would say are for intermediate to advanced users. The platform king that everybody knows is called Automatic 1111. Automatic 1111 is the most popular Stable Diffusion platform that most people use, mainly because it's so versatile. There's a lot of extensions that you can install on it that enable you to do so many different things like ControlNet, outpainting, you can install image galleries. There's a whole long list of stuff. Similar to Automatic 1111 in terms of the user interface is something called Vladmatic 1111. It's basically a fork of Automatic 1111. It's a bit more user-friendly because it comes with certain features already installed, like ControlNet and an image browser as an example. And then there's one of my favorites called Invoke AI, which is known for its outpainting capabilities. It's probably the better ones out there. That comes with this canvas editor where you could do something called inpainting and outpainting. The user interface is very intuitive, especially with the latest updates. Although it's not as robust as Automatic 1111, the inpaint and outpainting feature alone is well worth looking into. Then we have another platform called Comfy UI. Now this is node-based. I would say this is more for the advanced user that wants to understand the process in the pipeline of Stable Diffusion. It's almost like if you were to take automatic 1111 and check under the hood and see what's underneath. It allows for a lot of versatility and a lot of flexibility in terms of the process and pipeline. I'm still learning how to use it, but I find it very intuitive, and you can run it on a GPU that only has like 3 or 4 gigabytes, although it might be a bit slow, but I found that it's just a bit more snappier once you wrap your head around the whole node-based system. Now, once you've decided on a platform, what you'll need are Stable Diffusion models. So remember in the beginning, we talked about this data set being shrunk down to this 2 gigabyte file. Well, that 2 gigabyte file is known as a CKPT or safe tensor file. The most popular one is called Stable Diffusion 1.5. I started when it was 1.4 and then it updated to 1.5 just a few months after. Down the line, there was Stable Diffusion 2.0, but it wasn't really that popular because 1.5 was just more versatile, which we'll get into in a second. And then recently, a new model was just released, Stable Diffusion XL 0.9. But currently, Stable Diffusion 1.5 is the most popular. And the reason being is because there's a vast amount of custom models that were made based off Stable Diffusion 1.5. There's an online hub here called Civitai or Civit AI, where enthusiasts come to download different custom models. There's some popular ones like Realistic Vision, Dream Shaper, Deliberate. There's so many available, and they can be all had for free. Now, some of them have license terms, but for the most part, you can use them commercially. I would guarantee you that 95% of people, maybe more, use a custom model instead of using the raw Stable Diffusion 1.5. You're just going to get better results with a custom model. Now, they vary in terms of size. Some of them can be as high as 7 or 8 gigabytes. Some of them are only 1 or 2 gigabytes. But I guarantee you that you're going to download a lot of these, so make sure you have an ample amount of hard drive space. There are other sites like Hugging Face, which is sort of the main hub for anything Stable Diffusion, as well as GitHub. GitHub is where you'll find all the platforms, you'll find models there, and all the extensions for Stable Diffusion. And don't worry, I'm going to list all this information in a description below, or I might even make a short little document of everything we talked about today. Now, if you have these three things, a computer with a decent graphics card, and you've chosen a platform to run Stable Diffusion, and you've downloaded all those models, now you can create images. Now, some of you might be thinking, well, I don't have the right computer. I don't have the specs to run Stable Diffusion locally. Well, the good news is there are various sites online that you can use. The first place I would recommend is playgroundai.com. I currently work for them, so I'm a little biased here, and mainly because you can generate up to 1,000 images per day. There is a subscription model for pro users. It's $15 a month, and then you get all the access to the canvas features and all the other features that may be available. There's also Leonardo AI that works on a token-based system. The free version only gives you 150 tokens per day. And of course, they have various pricing options as well. And then there's also Prompt Hunt that is a subscription-based platform as well. I'm not sure about their free membership. I do remember it being very limited. I think it was something like 50 or 100 images. I could be wrong. You'll have to check it out for yourself. So regardless of which Stable Diffusion platform you use locally, whether it be Automatic 1111 or Invoke AI, or if you decide to use Playground AI online, these are all Stable Diffusion platforms that may just vary in terms of features and what's available. So now that you have a bit more background on what Stable Diffusion is and how you can run it, in the next video, I'm going to go through some basics. And I really encourage you to watch that video because everything I go through, I'm going to use one of the local platforms. But the concepts you're going to learn there apply to any platform, as long as that platform has the same features and options available. So technically, you could watch all my videos on Stable Diffusion and take those concepts and and bring them to any platform that you decide to use. As always, if you have any questions or feedback, let me know in the comments below. I'll be sure to answer them as soon as I can. But in the meantime, be sure to watch this video. And if it's not up, that means I'm just editing at the moment. Until then, I'll see you when I see you.